We made it. I want to take a short moment to thank all of you out there somewhere on this planet watching my videos. We earned the silver 100,000 subscriber award. Thank you guys very much. Really, I couldn't have done it without you. Next up, the 1 million award. We are back. This time we are in the Ardennes where the Battle of the Bulge took place. It truly is a very interesting area. Basically, it was Hitler's last major counteroffensive on the Western Front. The goal was to reach the port of Antwerp and split the Allied army in two parts. They wanted to try that in order to get some peace treaty, but obviously it has never come that far. We all know how the Battle of the Bulge turned out. The Germans lost. The Americans fought very bravely to achieve that. So yeah, let's hope we're gonna find some of that history. See you at the first find. A straight line on the map isn't always a horizontal walk. Yeah, we gotta do some serious vertical movement right here. You know, the quickest route is going straight, so that's what we're gonna do. First signs of foxholes, looking good. Okay, let's set up soon. Let's find a nice spot. I'm detecting this forest edge over here. And I actually just dug up my first signal and it's already something good. Here, check this out. It's an American .50 shell casing fired by the Browning machine gun. Sometimes it was mounted on jeeps. I think it was also the primary machine gun in airplanes. Yeah, very interesting. Here it even has it has a clear date on it. Let me just give you a close up. There it says M42. So the M is the fabricant, the manufacturer. 42 is the year it was produced, 1942. So my friends just called me over. And what do you have there? Is that an American X, you think?
An X, I'm not sure. Could be.
It looks quite old, still even has some wood.
Maybe if you clean it.
Well, yeah, if it is USA, maybe it's on there somewhere. But that's definitely a neat X. Well, I truly hope we're onto something. Just stuck up another one. It's the second one. And don't worry, I'm not only going to show you casings, but this one is actually from 1943. Look at this view, guys. I'm actually not surprised that we're finding so many of these .50 machine gun shell casings. Perfect machine gun position. The Americans will be laying here, not knowing the Germans are coming, but definitely prepared to fight them off. Just walking around in this ditch. Yeah. These guys just found some buttons and some cloth.
Yes, I'm not quite sure what it is, but some leather or something with
I think it's some
buttons
sort of
in it, yeah.
Some sort of canvas fabric. I think that's actually American. Yeah, you see these push buttons here, that's typical American. Maybe some ammo pouch was here. Not sure if you can hear that, but we have more signals. And we also found some more stuff. This very nice buckle just came out. Not quite sure what type of buckle it is, but I'm very sure that this is American. It's broken off here at the end, unfortunately. There in the back, you can see the guys digging up that. It's either an ammo pouch or a canteen pouch. And right here, it's a very nice foxhole. I hope I can make that visible to you. Foxhole with a view. Strategic position again. We might have stumbled on an American machine gun position, I think. We found so many of these Browning .50 shell casings. I really don't believe this. The guys are still digging over there in the back. I just showed you this foxhole right here. And I am digging in this trench over here. I think I discovered an American hand grenade. I'm not quite sure yet. I have to see, I'll be very careful with it. But right here, you can see the contours of a, what I think is an American US pineapple hand grenade. I'm gonna brush it off a little, and if it really is that, then I'll definitely show you. I did in fact find a hand grenade, an American pineapple hand grenade. There you can see the detonator is gone. A lot of American soldiers actually used this to make fire to warm up, because it really was an extremely cold period of time. We carefully brushed off some of the mud, and it quickly became clear that my thought was correct. There's no TNT or gunpowder in it anymore. So yeah, this one was used to make fire. That's clear now. We just made a surface find, small discovery, bottle, and we think it's from the Second World War. How is this thing called? It had a certain bottle top, and that's actually from quite an old model, I think. It has some markings, Ritter beer, and there's some more text there, and it actually says 39 at the bottom. So this could well be a beer bottle drank by either an American or a German soldier. I'm standing in a foxhole right here, and I just found these two live M1 Garand rounds. So that means that an American soldier has been sitting here firing his M1 Garand. I'm quite happy I'm not the German he was shooting at. Well, right next to my foxhole with the M1 Garand rounds, my buddy Kenny just shouted that he had something American, something World War II. He saw some markings. Let me see if I can focus that. Just keep it steady.
Not sure if it's readable yet.
Synthetic powder. Yeah, I think this is from an American ration, like lemonade powder. So they had some energy off of that. And yeah, you see, that's what I meant. If you find them, they don't really look like much. But if you unfold them carefully, they have a lot to reveal. More and more finds out of this foxhole, more M1 Garand rounds, and I even managed to pull out a part of an M1 Garand clip. You can see this clear circle pattern on the bottom. One side is missing, fortunately, but I'm not surprised I'm finding this along with all of these rounds. Found another ration bag, and this one actually, you can read, it says soluble coffee product. So it's a coffee bag, standard ration coffee bag. Also American. And actually, what's also quite funny is that I found the other side of the M1 Garand clip, and I exactly found 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 rounds here. So that's actually complete but broken M1 Garand clip. Here I just dug up a Nivea cream box. The design is quite basic, and it's, you can basically buy this still in the shop, very similar to this. But there you can see Nivea cream, the German writing, and
It's just some basic Vaseline to put on your skin and to keep it in good condition.
Well, unfortunately, the weather has made a turn for the worst. It's raining quite hard, but we're just gonna keep going. And luckily, it's paying off. When I was digging it out, I saw something shiny.
So I grabbed my camera and I wanted to do this together. Look at that. Well, clearly it's a coin, probably nickel. And oh, I think it says United States of America. Can you see that? I think that's a quarter or something. Let's turn it around. I don't want to rub it too much.
Right next to that coin signal, we actually have another nice signal, so I really hope we're gonna find some more coins. Let me just give you a better close-up of the one that Johan just found. There, you can clearly see the face, and I think it also reads Liberty. So yeah, it's definitely an American. Still have to find out what year is on it.
Right next to that other coin, here, you can see it for yourself. There is yet another coin. Let me just flip that over. Looking at the material, pretty sure that's again an American one.
A quick update of what we found in the last hour. So we found 6 coins in total. Some of them are American and some of them are a bit oxidized. So we're gonna have to clean that at home and then hope it reveals something. And we also found, again, an American ration bag, but this time it looks like we found some orange juice powder. So that's funny, because then we have orange juice powder, lemon juice powder, and also instant coffee. So then we have the full set. I couldn't help it, I rushed to the car, I cleaned these American coins with some water, and that's when I noticed that the 1788, that's some memorial date. At the bottom there you see the year 2000, and that's actually the date when this coin was made. So yeah, that's very strange, because that's a modern American quarter, and also a dime here. I don't know if you can see it, it's from 1985. And this dime is from 2005. So we found modern American coins in the Ardennes forest in Europe. Maybe a veteran came by in this forest to pay his respects to his fallen comrades. We gave it a quick Google search, and that actually confirmed our thoughts that these coins were left symbolically to remember these fallen soldiers. We found out that a dime means that you served with a soldier. Well, we found 2 dimes. And a quarter means that you were there when that soldier lost their life. So I'm not really sure what I should think about that, but I think the only honorable thing to do here is walk back into the forest and leave those coins right there, where probably a veteran left them behind. So that's what we're gonna do. I'm going to walk back and leave those coins there. Back home, I just wanted to give you a small Easter egg for next video, what's to come. Finally made the decision to buy an XP Deus. I got it from Detector Plaza. If you're looking for good quality products and an honest advice which detector suits you best, then yeah, you should definitely check out that link in the video description. Deus really is the best out there on the market. It's extremely light. Everything is wireless, so the headphone is wireless. There's a wireless connection between the pinpointer and the metal detector itself. And it actually has one of the highest recovery speed of all metal detectors. You also got a nice MI6 pinpointer with it. Wireless headphones. And a very nice bag for my finds. Yeah, I'm really looking forward to start using this in the forest and see what this beauty will bring me.